Look at this headline. The Weekly Standard is gone, but the future of conservatism is bright. I'm joined now by the author, John Burtka. He is executive director of the American Conservative. John, first let's talk about the face of the Republican Party or the GOP or even conservatism. Does Donald Trump now represent all of that?
Thanks so much for having me, Charles. Well, I think you'll see on the right now, there's been a lot of hand-wringing since the Weekly Standard closed several weeks ago about the future of the Republican Party and the conservative movement, where it's going. Has it been overrun by populists and demagogues? And I wrote my piece in the Washington Post to argue the exact opposite. In fact, I think the future of conservatism is bright, that it was a positive thing that Donald Trump broke the neoconservative hold on the Republican Party, which pretty much advocated for endless war and endless globalization since the end of the Cold War without taking into account the human costs of their policies. And I've been very encouraged at my work at the American Conservative, working with quite a few other conservative publications and thought leaders, developing what we call is a Main Street conservatism that cherishes
culture,
community,
and the common good. Let me ask you on
that note then, John.
John, who gets to decide what conservatism is? Because I hear a lot of people saying, well, you know, I have him on my show all the time. I've interviewed him. I've gone, you know, blow to blow because, you know, I don't believe that the idea that being pro-war, pro-trade status quo, pro-tax cuts only for the rich is what Main Street America wants on either side of the political aisle. But people tell me all the time that there's a set definition of what conservatism is, and that's just not it anymore. Does the voter get to decide? Who gets to decide what conservatism is?
Charles, the American people get to decide what conservatism is.
Right.
And in 2016, you saw an attempt to take back conservatism for the working class and for the middle class.
John,
and so I think it's...
I'm sorry, buddy. I got the answer I was looking for. I appreciate your article. I read it. It's great. We ran out of time, though. We're going to bring you back real soon. Great piece. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much for having me,
Charles. Look at this headline. The Weekly Standard is gone, but the future of conservatism is bright. I'm joined now by the author, John Burtka. He is executive director of the American Conservative. John, first let's talk about the face of the Republican Party or the GOP or even conservatism. Does Donald Trump now represent all of that?
Thanks so much for having me, Charles. Well, I think you'll see on the right now, there's been a lot of hand-wringing since the Weekly Standard closed several weeks ago about the future of the Republican Party and the conservative movement, where it's going. Has it been overrun by populists and demagogues? And I wrote my piece in the Washington Post to argue the exact opposite. In fact, I think the future of conservatism is bright, that it was a positive thing that Donald Trump broke the neoconservative hold on the Republican Party, which pretty much advocated for endless war and endless globalization since the end of the Cold War without taking into account the human costs of their policies. And I've been very encouraged at my work at the American Conservative, working with quite a few other conservative publications and thought leaders, developing what we call is a Main Street conservatism that cherishes
culture, community, and the common good.
Community, and the common good.
John, who gets to decide what conservatism is? Because I hear a lot of people saying, well, you know, I have him on my show all the time. I've interviewed him. I've gone, you know, blow to blow because, you know, I don't believe that the idea that being pro-war, pro-trade status quo, pro-tax cuts only for the rich is what Main Street America wants on either side of the political aisle. But people tell me all the time that there's a set definition of what conservatism is, and that's just not it anymore. Does the voter get to decide? Who gets to decide what conservatism is?
Charles, the American people get to decide what conservatism is.
Right.
And in 2016, you saw an attempt to take back conservatism for the working class and for the middle class.
John,
and so I think it's...
I'm sorry, buddy. I got the answer I was looking for. I appreciate your article. I read it. It's great. We ran out of time, though. We're going to bring you back real soon. Great piece. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much for having me,
Charles.